Hello, everybody. I'm painting a plein air painting with the inspiration of this cherry blossom. I try to make it into an imaginative painting rather, or creative painting rather than just copy of nature. So I just use that as inspiration, but not copying everything I see here. So I'm using the the trunk from the tree behind for this composition. This is my starting point. Usually we have a starting point in the Chinese brush painting. This is number one position. Now I develop diagonally to the right. I try to make sure I don't violate the rules, you know, avoid the center, and I use the thirds as my reference. So this goes up and down like that. And that is the supporting line. Do another supporting line, just for this. There will be lots of little tweaks. The negative space. Like that ending, so the ending should be complete. just outside the frame. Zillions of branches. The dense part. Sun comes up. Let's take a break. Now I decide to go for the background. So I got white and cerulean blue mix together. Purple, just the kind of gray. You don't have to blend it too much, just let it blend on the paper. It's a warm kind of lavender blue. And you can have some dark in the dance part, because it will be covered by flowers. I tried the canvas with a heavy gesso or modeling paste, so it has a texture already. Even I paint thin, it's going to show that. There is a horizon here, I think I need to indicate that in this painting. Try to make it kind of semi-landscape. It's the inspiration of this place. There's some purplish gray in the background. This purple and the yellow. Whatever. It's a mixture of dried branch and green grass. That's what it is. Like a hill in the background. Warm gray. But you want to keep the value light. I think that's more important than the hue. Okay, there's some dark here, greens. Mix red with blue and yellow. It's too dark. I think I'm gonna go for it. Some distant layer with some more blue for sure and some purplish gray kind of. Distant. I want to color the whole ground quickly so we can work on the main objective. Well, there should be lots of grass here. I think there still are. Just some grass. Mix the color on the palette, on the paper, instead of on the palette. So just yellow, mix some red. It dries pretty fast. Yellow, blue, rainbow colors, you know.
Excuse me, can I see your tiny?
Sure.
Oh wow, that looks really nice. Are you painting this one right here?
Yeah.
It looks nice.
Thank you.
Bye, have a good day.
You too.
Very nice. Very nice.
Yeah, I want to see.
I can't with this guy.
And he answered me. For something that you want to sit down. So I'm talking about it. What I do is more
stuff. Hey, good. What's up? You want to talk? I'm going to sit down.
Into the flowers now. Lots of buds, red, pink, blue, greenish. So, I'm adding some greens to it. It's a very impressionistic approach. I'm not concentrated on individuals, flowers, but now morning and many on the whole tree.
Thank you. 这个花拉过来。
挺不错的，这张是
生物学家。这张是生物学
家。每张照片给你按一个头衔。
漂亮。哇塞，这里又装了又拍了一大堆的照片。刘平，我们出去啦！
来看看。你拿墨镜，拿掉墨镜。
finishing touch is the kind of brown yellow color in the center for the stamen. I'm not going to do it like a flower and birds, but more like an landscape. So just accent. Actually, the center is kind of dark dot in many cases, create a contrast. Okay, that's it. I'm going to sign it now. Gotta be red and orange. Okay. The sign here. The H from Blue Heron logo. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.